Now let us take some more examples to understand the concept in a better way. So if we are to find cot of minus 31 or minus 317 pi by 2 plus theta. So first of all, tan of negative argument is minus tan of that argument. So cot is its reciprocal, so this will also give a negative outside. So negative of cot 317 pi by 2 minus theta. Now check where this 317 pi by 2 lies. So on dividing 317 by 4, we need to divide only 17 by 4. If we divide this 17 by 4, the remainder will be 1. So those numbers which give remainder 1 and multiples of pi by 2 lie on this line. Okay, it lies here. And if we subtract theta from it, we will come a little backwards. So it will lie in first quadrant. So this number was lying in first quadrant. Cot lies in first quadrant. All are positive in first quadrant. So this will remain positive. A negative was already there. So from cot we will write tan, because we have added theta or subtracted theta in multiples of pi by 2, odd multiples of pi by 2. So this will become minus tan theta. Let us take another example. We go for tan of 113 pi by 2 minus 113 pi by 2 plus theta. So if we take out 1 minus, this will become minus tan 113 pi by 2 minus theta. So first of all, tan will change to cot, because we are adding angles in odd multiples of pi by 2. So this tan will change to cot, and here theta will come, and 1 minus was already present. We have to find if this tan generates a positive or negative according to the quadrant. So check where does this lie. 113 113 pi by 2. So on dividing 11 by 113 by 4 or last two digits by 4, we get 1 as a remainder. So the numbers which give 1 as a remainder lie here. We are subtracting theta from it, so we will lie in first quadrant. In first quadrant, this tan is positive, so we will put here a positive sign. So the answer will be minus cot of theta. Let's take one more example. If we write cos of minus 119 pi by 2 plus theta. So if we try to take out minus, it will not be taken out, because cos is an even function. It will absorb this minus, because cos of minus theta and cos of theta are same thing. So this will become cos of 119 pi by 2 minus theta. So where will this 119 lie? 119 on dividing by 4 will give us remainder 3, because the last digits are 19, and on dividing by 4 we will get 3 as a remainder. So we are standing over this line, and we are to subtract theta. So we are to lie here in third quadrant. This angle will lie in third quadrant. First of all, this cos will be changed to sine, because we are adding angles in odd multiples of pi by 2. This will be changed to sine theta. And in third quadrant, this cos, because we will talk about the terms lying on the left hand side, which was originally given. Originally cos was given. We will check if cos is positive in third quadrant or not. So no, it is not positive. Tan was positive. So here we will put one negative sign. So it will be converted to minus sin theta. Let us take one more example. If we write tan of minus 31127 pi plus theta. So what will we do? Will we divide it by 4? No, we will not be dividing it by 4, because it is not a multiple of pi by 2. It is a multiple of pi. And is it a odd multiple or even multiple? It is an odd multiple of pi. So if it is an odd multiple of pi, it will lie here. And if we are adding theta in it, we will be going forward. Forward in trigonometry means anti-clockwise. We will be going anti-clockwise. So we will be lying in third quadrant. Before this analysis, we can write it only tan theta, because we are adding angle in multiples of pi. So tan will remain in tan. It will not be converted to cot. Now let us check it will be positive or negative. We are lying in third quadrant and the original expression was tan. Tan in third quadrant is positive, so answer will be plus 10. Let us check one more example. If we write cos of, or in place of cos, let it be sine of 3127 pi by 2 plus theta. If we write like this, this is a multiple of pi by 2. So on dividing 27 by pi by 2, on dividing 27 by 4, what will be the remainder? This will be 3. The 3 will lie here, but here one negative was present, so we'll reverse our process. This will lie here because of one negative. Okay, now we are adding theta in it. If we are adding theta in it, we will go forward in second quadrant. So we are in second quadrant now. Sine will be changed to same sine. It will remain same sine because we it will be changed to cos because we are adding it in multiples of pi by 2. So it will be changed to cos. This sign will be changed to cos of theta. And will it be positive or negative? We were lying in second quadrant. In second quadrant, this sign remains positive. So this will be cos theta. Or if we do not reverse our process, what can we simply do? We can take one minus out of here. So we can write minus sine 3127 pi by 2 and it becomes minus theta. So on dividing 27 by 4, the remainder is 3. This will lie here. And if we subtract theta, what will happen? We are to come backwards and this is third quadrant. So first of all, sine will be changed to cos because we are adding some angle theta in multiples of pi by 2. So it will become cos theta. One minus sign was already present. Now due to quadrants, will we put a positive sign or a negative sign? This sign has come in third quadrant, and in third quadrant we know only tan theta is positive, all other ratios are negative, so we will put one more negative sign and this becomes cos theta. So to avoid this reversal of process, when this negative was present with pi by 2, I have simply told you the formula that you can take this minus out like we did in this. So you will not have to reverse the process. Let us take another example. Example 6. If we do like this, sine of minus 31 pi plus theta. So now it doesn't matter if this is positive or negative. We are to just see if they are multiples of odd multiples of pi or even multiples of pi. If odd multiples of pi, they will lie on this line. If we are adding theta in it, we will go forward. We will come in third quadrant and sine will remain unchanged. It will be sine because we are adding theta in even multiples of pi, or we can say simply multiples of pi, not multiples of pi by 2. Okay, so this will remain sine and we have to put a positive and negative. So how we will decide? In third quadrant, only tan and cot are positive, sine will be negative, so the answer will be minus sine. Let us take one more example. If we talk about tan of 312 pi plus theta, so it is an even multiple of pi, so it will lie here, either positive or negative, it doesn't matter in case of multiples of pi. If negative also, then it will lie here. If positive also, it will lie here. Now we are adding theta. If we are adding theta, we are going forward. Forward in trigonometry means anti-clockwise. So we have come in first quadrant, and tan will remain unchanged because we have added angle theta in multiples of pi, not in multiples of pi. So it will remain tan theta, and in first quadrant, the expression which was given to us tan remains positive. So I hope you have understood it. Now, a lot of students have doubt that we have made this process for acute angles only, when some acute angle was added in this multiples of pi by 2 or multiples of pi. So this is wrong. This can be either acute angle or an obtuse angle. It doesn't matter. The sign will be automatically taken care. If it would have been an acute angle, then there is no problem according to the student. But if it would have been an obtuse angle, then the quadrant that we have found would have been changed. But it will be automatically taken care, because if this theta would have been obtuse, then the ratio would have been already negative or positive according to the trigonometric ratio. So it doesn't matter either the angle is acute or obtuse. We can always follow this process. Hope you understand.